Welcome back to another exciting chemistry lesson. In this lesson, we are going to look at electromagnetic radiation. Now, you have heard of visible light. These are the light that allow us to see with our naked eyes. And then we have radio waves, X-ray, gamma rays, ultraviolet, and infrared radiation. Now, all this radiation that we just went over, all of them have a dual probabilities that exist in both wave-like and particle light. So here are the wave light that we are referring to, okay? The wave probability. But it also exists as a photon. A photon is a unit which as a particle like, and we are going to talk about that when we talk about energy. But for now, let's look at this. So first of all, let's talk about the wave. Well, the wave has little peaks right here. They are considered as the crest. And down here, we have the little lower peak down here. They are known as the trough. So the trough and the crest are the peak in a wave, and then from one crest to another crest, or from one trough to another trough, we have a wavelength. Then half the distance between the crest and the trough, we have the amplitude. So that is a basic. So that is a basic characteristic of a wave. Now let's go down and look at this image and talk about in terms of frequency. Electromagnetic radiation can also be described in terms of frequency, wavelength, speed, amplitude, and energy. But for now, if we look at this right here, this will tell us the frequencies as well as the wavelength. If we notice, let's look at this. Here we have the distance travel in 1 second. So all of these waves, this type of wave, travel in 1 second. But notice how they have different cycles. So for this one, it has 3 cycles, okay? 1, 2, and 3. So you can see that right there. 1, 2, 3 cycles. And here we have, how many cycles does it have? We have 6 cycles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cycles. And down here we have 12 cycles. So these three type of waves tell us the three different type of frequency. If you notice right here, we have hertz. Hertz is basically the number of cycles per second. So that's hertz. Now, if we look at this, which one have a higher frequency? So this one, of course, it has higher frequency. So therefore, as you can see, the hertz number is a lot greater. So this picture allows us to understand the difference between low frequency and high frequency. And over here, we have a good example of the difference between lower amplitude and versus high amplitude. And we will talk more about that later. Now let's go down and relate this to an equation. So as you can see right here, the speed of light is equal to wavelength times frequency. That is why C is equal to lambda times V. So this lambda right here, again, is your wavelength. And V is for frequency. But most importantly, this speed of light, that is a constant values. It doesn't change. So you have to realize this is a constant values. So that part of the equation, this variable is not a variable, it's a constant. It's a constant values for speed of light. So what does that tell you about the relationship between a frequency and lambda? So if I go right here, C over lambda equal to V, right? You see how this is the numerator and this denominator. As frequency go up, guess what happened to lambda? Lambda went down. And this relationship right here is illustrated in this picture here. The greater the frequency, look what happened to the wavelength, it gets smaller. But in terms of greater wavelength, look what happened to the frequency, it gets smaller. So they have an inverse relationship. So this is inverse relationship. That is, one gets larger, the other one gets smaller. And one of the most important things we have to realize when we look at this equation is that the speed of light, this is in meter, but a lot of time lambda is given to you in nanometer. So what do you have to do? You have to convert to meter first, okay? So that's the most important thing. And then sometime frequency is given you in different time frame, but if it is, you have to convert to second, and you all know how to do that already. So let's solve a problem. So again, be careful with the unit. That's the most important thing. You have to be careful with the unit. The wavelength has to be measured in meter, and frequency has to be measured in per second. Now let's do an example problem. An emission spectrum of an elemental gas has a frequency of 4.0 × 10⁴ per second. And a lot of times they write second like that. That's basically per second. Calculate the wavelength in nanometers of light that correspond to this line, okay? Here's a trick. They want it in nanometer. That's probably the trickiest part, but it's also the easiest part. So we have C equal to what? Lambda times V, wavelength times frequency. So in this case, we are solving for wavelength. So wavelength is basically C divided by V. Easy, right? We just bring this over here. As simple as that. Now let's plug it in. So wavelength is 3.0 times 10 to the 8th. This will never change. Notice how I did not write the unit because I don't want to mix it up, but we had to keep it in our head all the time. So in this case, frequency is what? 4.0 times 10 to the 14. Now again, if you plug this in your calculator, you can use the e power button right here, right? Same thing with this one to make your life a lot easier, so that way we don't make a lot of mistakes. Use the e button right there. And that turned out to be what? So once we plug in our calculator, we have 7.50 times 10 to the negative 7. Now this is in meter, but we want it to nanometers, so we had to convert that. So again, we have 1 meter equal to what? 10 to the 9 nanometer, okay? And that's all we had to do. Now we can cross it out. So again, this is multiplication, so we just add them together. If you're using this, if you are doing this on a multiple choice, you can just add the exponent together, okay? So in this case, 7.50 times 10 to the negative 7 plus 9. What's that going to give to you? 2. So this is to the second power nanometer. So our answer could be 7.50 e to the second, or 750 to be exact. So either one will be fine. So 750 nanometer. Let's go to the next one. A sodium light give off a yellow light that has a wavelength of 589 nanometer. So again, this is nanometer, so we had to convert it to meter. What is that gonna be? What is easy? What's nano? Nano is times 10 to the negative 9. So 589 times 10 to the negative 9. There you go. Isn't that nice? That's how we use the prefix, okay, without going through the math. But I'm just still going to show you how the math works as well. So 589 nanometer time, and we know that 1 meter is equal to 10 to the 9 nanometer. And again, when we divide, we just bring it to the top right. So we have 589 times 10 to the negative 9 nanometer. So again, the nanometer cancel out. There you go. So you can see how we can use the exponent rule to make our math process a lot faster, right? If this is multiple choice. So let's plug in the calculator. We have C equal lambda times V. So in this case, we are solving for frequency, so V, right? So V is equal to C. So remember, C is a constant. So let's plug in our calculator. C is the speed of light constant, so 3.0 times 10 to the 8th. And we have to keep in mind that our unit needs to be in, and we have to keep in mind that C is in the unit of meter over second. So we have a meter over here, so that's good. So now we plug it in. In this case, 589 times 10 to the negative 9. We always have to keep our unit in mind, okay? Then we plug into our calculator. We have 5.09 times 10 to the 14. And this is per second. So this is per second, okay? And that is our answer. And if you type this in, we can use the E button, E to the 14. That should take our answer as well. So let's go check our answer. So for right here, we have 750 nanometer. There you go. Let's go check the other one. And let's check our second answer, 5.09 E to the 14. And there you go. And as always, if you have any question, please take a picture of your work, put it on your Google Drive, and share the link on the forum, and we will help you from there. And we'll see you next time on another chemistry video.